Hey everyone, it's Dr. Evan. Today, we're going to talk about the new process for the bio screening before you take a Salesforce test. First things first, you want to make sure you have a government ID. You now have to provide an ID before you go ahead and take the test. Should make sure that your ID matches the name on your web assessor account. If they don't match, they're not going to let you take the test. If you use a nickname on your web assessor account, change it so it matches your government ID, then you won't have any issues. Next thing, you probably want to give yourself a little extra time logging in to take the test. You can set the test early, but you're going to wait in a little bit of a queue. I was told when I went through this process that it could be up to 15 minutes. I waited about 5 minutes before I was able to speak to somebody to basically start this whole process. So you may need some additional time when blocking out that time to take the test in order to do this verification process. Before we move on to the next one, please like and subscribe. I do produce Salesforce tips every week. Next thing you want to do is clear off your desk. I had some things in my desk and they started asking questions about it. In the end, I just cleared everything off my desk because it was easier. They were totally fine with an empty desk. If you have things in your desk, they're going to ask what they are and what they're supposed to be there for. So be prepared to answer questions if you have a lot of things in your desk. Like I said, easiest way to do this, have a clear desk, just like the picture, just have your laptop or computer. And the last thing is to clean your room. It's not really a necessity, but just one of those pride things. You're going to have to show all four walls of your room, make sure nobody's in there. They may ask you to move around in your room. So make sure your room's clean, unless you're totally fine with them looking at all your stuff. That's fine. But just take it in an area that it may be an area that you don't want to show off everything in your room. One of the cool things that came out of this whole update is that you now have notes you can take. So you now have a scratch piece of paper. It uses half the space of the exam. I really wasn't a big fan of it because I like reading the whole question straight across, not half and half. But if you're one of the people that likes to have scratch paper, you now have the option. So it's kind of a cool thing. This is a benefit that you get out of this whole entire process, is that you now get some scratch paper to take your notes on. All right, thanks for coming, and I'll see you next time.